Hey guys, Paisteboy here. Just gonna give you a little update before we get started with this video where I'm gonna change the oil on my snowblower. But yeah, starting like New Year's Eve, weather warmed up here and we even had rain yesterday, melted all the snow, haven't been able to do any riding with the sled, so that kind of sucks. And haven't had to use the snowblower either, obviously. There's no snow out there whatsoever. This morning it did cool off a little bit and some snow is coming down, but I don't know if it's going to accumulate to anything. But I want to say Happy New Year and thanks for watching. And let's get started with the oil change. All right, there's the snow blower over there. And first thing I'm going to do before we get started is start it up, let the engine warm up a little bit. That'll let the oil come out a lot easier. And so let's do that first. This is what it looks like out right now. I mean, 100% of the snow melted, but yeah, a little bit's coming down it. I don't think it's gonna amount to squat, but can only hope. So gotta change the oil here. And if we get enough snow, we can ride that. So let's pull this out and start her up, get it warmed up a little bit. Alright, there's basically three things I'm going to need to do this oil change. An oil pan to catch the oil, a 5/8 inch wrench to loosen the nut to drain the oil, and the proper 5W30 four cycle engine oil. So I believe this particular motor, it's a 10 horse or 10 and a half horse, takes 28 ounces of oil. So if that's a full quart, I won't need all of it. But so the first step is to loosen up the nut and start draining the oil. I'm also going to use a vice grip to hold this pipe because it looks like it wants to spin instead of the nut. I'm also going to unscrew the dipstick, which will help slightly with airflow, I suppose. Now that's going to take about a minute. That ought to do it. So now I'm going to put the cap back on. Make sure that's all good and tight. That ought to do it. Alright, let's move the dipstick. Got a funnel here so we don't make a mess. And this is the oil. So looks like here this is a full quart 32 ounce bottle and I only need 28 ounces. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to pour, you know, a good 3/4 or more in and then let that settle for a second, check it, and you know, you could also read the bottle. It'll kind of tell you how much is
left in the bottle on the side.
Now, I don't know if you could see that on the side of the bottle. I gotta hold it level too. But from what I can see, there's about 10 ounces left in the bottle. So since it was 32, that means I put in 22. I need to put a little bit more in. All right, we're about 5 ounces left. Let's just check it real quick. All right, I got a fresh rag here. Let's clean this off. All right, so that looks clean. We should be to this line here. If you can see that, it says full. Perfect. So, that's about it. Simple as that. It really is a super basic job. I'm just showing you guys. But anybody could do that. So, basically, the right amount of oil. Warm it up first. You know, you do those few steps and it's a really simple job. Let's take it back outside and just start it back up.
Looks like the snow's coming down a little bit. Fine with me. Not even gonna prime it.
That sputters a little bit. It probably needs a carb cleaning, but it really does run pretty good. I mean, it doesn't hesitate at all when I'm blowing snow, so I'll get around to that too. But looks like it's snowing a little bit. I mean, it isn't accumulating to much, but it looks pretty steady. And if you take a look at my van here, you know, I mean, since we started the video, we got a little bit. But, so that's it, guys. Thanks for watching, and Happy New Year.